Halo semuanya, jumpa lagi dengan saya, Salam PPG Indonesia. Semoga sehat selalu dan tetap semangat ya. Dalam video kali ini, saya ingin menampilkan praktek pengalaman mengajar saya yang kedua dalam program PPG Daljab Angkatan 2 Bahasa Inggris tahun 2021. Di sini, saya akan mengajarkan bagaimana peserta didik bisa menggunakan kalimat conditional past and past perfect dalam percakapan sehari-hari. Seperti biasa ya, akan ada 3 langkah pembelajaran. Yang pertama yaitu kegiatan pembukaan dengan apersepsi dan motivasi. Yang kedua adalah kegiatan inti dengan model pembelajaran project based learning. Dan yang ketiga adalah kegiatan penutup dengan refleksi dan pemberitahuan kegiatan belajar berikutnya. Selamat menyaksikan ya!
Okay, good morning everyone.
Morning, Miss.
Okay, good morning. Yeah, welcome back again to English class with me. Today we are going to continue our previous lesson about conditionals. So before we start the lesson, I would like to confirm your attendance first. As I see in the Google Classroom, you have confirmed your attendance. There are 27 in this Zoom meeting. There are 18 students. Masih banyak yang belum ya. So I hope they can join the meeting soon, yeah? Alright. So don't forget, as usual, you have to open your cam and put yourself in a good position in frame so I can see you there. So now, before we start the learning, please, Jogi Nanda, you may lead the pray now. Please, Jogi.
Okay, Miss. Okay, class, before we start our lesson today with Miss Priska, it's good for us to pray together. Praying start. Praying finish.
Okay, thank you, Jogi. Today, we are going to continue our previous lesson. Do you still remember what we have learned in the previous lesson?
Conditional type 2 dan 3.
Yes, good. Conditional type 2 and type 3, yeah? Alright, so now, let's have a review about the conditionals lesson. There are 3 parts. The first is social function, and then the second is sentence structure, and then the third is language features. Okay, first is social function. What are the social functions of conditionals? Do you still remember? Please answer. What are the
showing regret?
Showing regret. Good. Yeah. Stating.
Criticism.
Okay. Good. What else?
Giving advice.
All right. What else?
Imaginary wish.
Yeah. Stating imaginary wish and dreams. Good. And then the last one is
stating unreal possibility.
Good. Yeah. So you have noted, yeah, all of the social functions of conditionals. Good. Now, how about the sentence structure?
If clause plus main clause.
Okay. If clause-nya di depan ya, main clause-nya di belakang. Okay. Very good. You still remember too about the sentence structure. Now, the last one, it is about the language features. The types first. What types of conditionals that we have learned in the last meeting?
Type 2 and type 3.
Okay, now one by one. Type 2, what tenses we use in the if clause for type 2? Yes?
Simple past.
Okay, good. Simple past. Good. How about the main clause?
Using past future simple, could, or might, plus verb 1.
All right, good. Using past future simple, using would, could, might, plus verb 1. Yeah, okay, good. So now, what about the type 3?
The if clause is using past perfect, plus verb 3.
Had plus verb 3, past perfect. Good. How about the main clause?
The main clause is using past future perfect with would, could, might, plus have verb 3.
Okay, good. You are all great. You still remember all the social functions, sentence structures, and also the language features. Okay, now let's see how we can use the conditionals in our daily conversation. Okay, I want to share you this. I have a video here. Yeah, pay attention to the conversation in this video. And I have the questions after this. Yeah, all right.
What would you do if you didn't have to work?
What do you mean?
If you were rich and didn't have to work.
But I'm not rich and I do have to work.
I know, but what if you won the lottery or you found $1 million?
But I don't play the lottery and I don't think anyone would lose or forget $1 million.
Look, stop being difficult. I know these things aren't probable, but they also aren't impossible. Do you just like to know what you would do if you didn't work, and could do anything you wanted? For example, would you travel?
Traveling is expensive.
Right, and therefore neither of us can do it, because we both aren't rich. Please open your mind and answer my question.
If I were rich, I'd buy my boss's company, that way I could make a lot of money.
But you would already have a lot of money.
Well, I suppose I'd stop taking the bus to work, and buy a car so I could drive to work. Well, why are you asking me this?
Because I just won the lottery and I quit my job. Pack your bag. Pack all your bags and get out.
Yeah. What did the man ask to the woman?
What would you do if you didn't have to work?
Yeah. What would you do if you didn't have to work and were rich? Okay, yeah. All right. So now, how did the woman reply?
The woman replied, so difficult because she is not rich and has a job.
Okay. But the woman said what she would do if she were rich.
She would buy her bus company.
Yeah, if she were rich, she would buy her bus company. So this is example of the conversation using conditionals. Yeah, so you can use the conditional to make an imaginary wish. This is the example. Do you understand the video so far?
Yes, miss.
Yes? Okay, good.
Yes.
So now let's have a practice with dialogues. Okay, I have a dialogue here. This is Joss and Ron. I want to ask William, you may read as Joss, and then Gentam, you can speak as Ron, yeah? All right, come on.
Okay, my phone when I got out of the car. I'm sorry, Levi, it's not broken.
The scratches are everywhere. If I were you, I would buy a new phone.
I would buy the new one if I had more money.
What if you start saving?
I can't, since I just lost my job.
Don't worry, Josh.
Yeah, if I have a job, I will start saving.
Yeah, alright. So... now, let's see another dialogue. Okay, complete the blank spaces with these clauses, yeah? Itulah contoh-contoh situasi using conditionals in dialogues. Nah, saya sudah berikan project ke kalian untuk mengerjakan conversation. Oke ya, saya mau ingatkan lagi untuk pesertanya. Di sini saya bacakan kelompok pasangannya ya, students in pairs. The first is Vero and Kylie, and then Jihan and Joy. And next, Angel and Amanda, Adit and Zega, Sirin and Alisa, and then the last is Jogi and Genta, Lilis and Melissa, William and Fajar, Yoel and Bevan, Anin and Hilwa, Fahmi and Alvin, kemudian Mutiara and Yoana ya. Oke, sekarang boleh ditampilkan bagi yang sudah selesai untuk projectnya. Yang pertama, the video from Vero and Kylie.
Vero, why do you look sad?
Everyone had brought a dish, but I didn't bring any dishes for the dinner party today.
Why didn't you bring the dish?
I didn't know that I supposed to bring a dish. If I knew, I would buy it.
I feel bad for you. If I were you, I would buy more dishes at the next dinner party.
That's a good idea. Anyway, what dish should I buy for the next dinner party?
How about tteokbokki and corn dog? If you bring it, Jenny and Anna will absolutely love it.
Sounds good. I will buy more tteokbokki and corn dogs and other Korean food for you too.
I can wait. Well, see you at the next dinner party. Don't forget to bring it.
Of course, you too.
Okay, thank you for the project for Vero and Kylie. Ya, tadi ada conditional sentence yang dipakai. Yang ini ya, if I knew, I would buy it. Ya, nah ini ada lagi, if I were you, I would buy more. This is at the next dinner party. Ada ya, jadi menunjukkan penyesalan. Oke, sekarang kita lanjut Angel dan Amanda.
Hi everyone, so today we want to show you the result of our projects that has been going on. So without waiting any longer, let's see the result.
Wait Amanda, we have to introduce ourselves first. So my name is Angel and this is my partner Amanda. We're from 12 IPS. So let's continue. What's wrong with you? It seems you look so sad.
What a bad trouble I have.
What is that?
I haven't got a job until now. I'm afraid if I didn't have any work like this, I wouldn't get any income. So how could I pay my needs?
Oh, I see. Since you told me about this, I might give you some help.
Really? But I don't want to bother you.
Hey, I'm your best friend. Don't worry. By the way, my uncle needs an employer in his restaurant. As waiter, maybe? Are you interested?
Really? Of course I want it. You are very helpful.
Nice helping my friend like you, Amanda. So, may I give your phone number to my uncle so he can contact you for the application needs?
With pleasure. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, Amanda.
Okay, so far this dialogue is very good. From the pronunciation and then the intonations and also the expressions. Yeah, this is very good. Okay, next, Gi and Genta.
Hello, Genta. Good morning. Where are you right now?
I'm driving my way back home from the hospital. What's the problem?
I need some time to talk to you. But just keep driving. I will call you back when you arrive at home.
Don't hang up the phone. Just tell me right now.
Okay, then. But wait, did you hear a police siren sound?
Yes, of course, there's a police. If I didn't answer your call, I wouldn't have been pulled over by the police.
If you were listening to my advice, you would be at home right now.
$2,000 for this is a huge fine.
If I were you, I would not tell my parents about this.
My parents will be really mad. Okay then, see you later.
See you later at the police station then.
Good, yeah? Okay, using conditional type. Alright, okay, thank you very much for all the projects that have you done. Saya masih menunggu yang lainnya yang masih belum, dan bagi yang sudah mengerjakan, I will return your grades then in the Google Classroom, ya. Now, let's have a evaluation for this material, ya. Okay, ini quiznya, kalian klik quizzes, kemudian join. 10 question only for conditionals. Let's have a review whether you understand about the lesson or not. We will check your comprehension here ya, yeah, by doing this quiz. Oke, saya start ya. Sudah ada 24 sepertinya, sudah semua. You may do in 1, 2 and 3. Okay, congratulations for the good one ya. Yeah, there are 20. Wow, nilainya bagus ya. Tapi akurasinya masih 73. Pasti beragam nih ya. Ada yang sangat bagus, ada juga yang masih kurang ya. Untuk bagi yang kurang mengerti dan kurang bisa, nanti kita akan ada pembelajaran tambahan lagi. Bagi kalian yang sudah, okay, congratulations ya, yeah, because you have understand all the lessons ya. Yeah. Thank you very much for the evaluation today. Alright, so now let's close this meeting today. So let's move again to Google Classroom. Seperti biasa anak-anak, after you have a lesson, I will assign the student's reflection here. Ya, nanti kamu boleh isi lagi student's reflection yang kedua, nanti isinya akan seperti ini. Ya, write your answer as your reflection after learning conditionals today. As usual, you may write your name and then within this learning material and activity, what you have learned today. And then second, what I like most of this material and activity is or are. And then things that I have improved from the previous learning is. Nah, ini yang beda dari pertanyaan sebelumnya adalah yang bagian ini. Hal yang perlu saya perbaiki dari pembelajaran sebelumnya. Ya, dan yang terakhir adalah what I need to improve, what I need to learn and practice more from this last learning. Please write your answer, yeah. We finish this material, yeah. Thank you very much for today, students. You're very good. Don't don't forget, I'm still waiting for another students group project in pairs. Ya, nanti saya akan ingatkan lagi di WhatsApp group siapa saja yang belum mengumpulkan. And please finish the project. See you next week. We will continue to the next chapter about causal conjunction, ya, and menggunakan so, that, and such. Ya? Okay, thank you very much for today. Bye, students.
Bye, miss. Thank you, miss.
Thank you, miss.
Thank you, too.